Meghan Markle married Prince Harry in May 2018, and they now have a four-month-old son, Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor. The famous couple announced their engagement in November 2017 after a 16-month romance. Before meeting Harry, Meghan was a high-profile actress based in Canada and known for her role in US TV series Suits. Meghan, born and raised in LA, married a Hollywood producer and director, Trevor Ingleson, in 2011 at a beach resort in Jamaica. They divorced 2 years later due to irreconcilable differences. In the past, the royal family have strictly forbidden heirs marrying divorcees. However, Meghan was welcomed into the royal family very quickly. Royal expert Duncan Larcom explained there were two main elements to Meghan's previous marriage which meant her past did not affect Harry's decision to marry her. He said, Meghan and her former husband weren't married for very long, so there isn't tremendous baggage. But also she didn't have children. If she did have children with her first husband, then that really would make it quite awkward and difficult to work out. By marrying Prince Harry, she immediately joins the royal family and all her children that she has will have a position within succession to the throne. So those issues have been rather conveniently avoided. This is a stark contrast to how the royal family has operated in the past. In 1936, Edward VIII, the Queen's uncle, was not able to keep the throne and marry the woman of his choice because she was divorced. He had fallen in love with Wallace Simpson, an American divorcee. However, marrying after divorce was opposed by the Church of England. This led to Edward's abdication, and meant the Queen's father, George VI, inherited the throne in his elder brother's place. A similar situation arose when the Queen's sister, Princess Margaret, wanted to marry a divorced group captain Peter Townsend. The Church of England did not allow her divorced lover to remarry. Princess Margaret then married photographer Anthony Armstrong Jones and bore two children. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle recently announced they intended to only have two children in total because they are conscious of the environmental impacts of having a large family. His brother, Prince William, and his wife Kate Middleton already have three children, Prince George, 6, Princess Charlotte, 4, and Prince Louis, 1. There are also rumors that Kate would like a fourth, although nothing has been confirmed. Harry and Meghan used to live on the same estate as William and Kate in Kensington Palace, but recently moved to live in Frogmore Cottage, in Windsor. This fueled speculation that the four of them had fallen out, especially as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex then pulled out of their shared charitable trust, the Royal Foundation. Prince Harry also celebrated his 35th birthday at the weekend. Meghan Markle sacrificed a lot when she tied the knot with Britain's beloved Prince Harry. Here's one thing Meghan will never be able to do again now she's a royal family member. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry won hearts all over the world with their spectacular royal wedding last May. Their transatlantic love story is the stuff of fairy tales, but former actress Meghan had to make several big sacrifices when she tied the knot with a British prince. Meghan, 38, made a name for herself as an actress long before Prince Harry, 34, came on the scene and was best known for her role as Rachel Zane in the legal sitcom Suits. However, Meghan was more than just a sitcom star, she was also an enthusiastic lifestyle blogger. The future Duchess ran her own blog The Tick, which she described as a hub for the discerning palate. She regularly updated the blog with fashion, food, beauty, and travel tips and shared heartfelt messages with her readers. However, Meghan shut down the blog in 2017 ahead of her wedding to Prince Harry, and despite rumors of a return, a palace source has claimed it will not make a comeback. Royal fans were sent into a spin after Meghan's business manager Andrew Meyer filed documents in the United States for Meghan to keep the rights for her lifestyle site. But the move was to stop anyone from taking on the name and pretending to be the Duchess, a palace source has claimed. The source told People magazine, "Absolutely no plans to relaunch the Tick. The lasting trademark is to prevent false branding, to avoid others purporting to be the Duchess or affiliated with her." When Meghan became a royal family member, she shut down her individual social media profiles to operate under the Sussex royal brand instead. While royal family members, including the Queen and Prince Philip, use social media, they have official accounts rather than individual accounts of their own. So when Meghan married Harry, she had to get used to sharing a social media profile with her new husband and give up having a presence of her own. Meghan's final post on the TIG, which she had previously described as her passion project, was a moving message to fans. The post, which was titled "Farewell, Darling," read, "To all my TIG friends, after close to 3 beautiful years on this adventure with you, it's time to say goodbye to the TIG. What began as a passion project, my little engine that could, evolved into an amazing community of inspiration, support, fun, and frivolity. You've made my days brighter and filled this experience with so much joy. Keep finding those TIG moments of discovery, keep laughing and taking risks, and keep being the change you wish to see in the world. Above all, don't ever forget your worth, as I've told you time and time again, you, my sweet friend, you are enough."